TiE is an amazing story of immigrants trained in science and technology who have really made it big. This is the Mecca of entrepreneurship. 80% of our ecosystem is now outside Silicon Valley in 53 cities in 12 countries.
Incubators cannot be the same in different locations in India because each location has its own strengths and weaknesses. You have to try and design your incubator around the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats, the SWOTs behind them, around them.
A National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board was established in the department in the year 1982 by the then Prime Minister of India, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. The mandate that was given to us was to develop technopreneurship.
Our primary target is academic and R&D institutions because we feel that they are the seedbed of innovation and new ideas. And as already told by Professor Rafiq, that for Indian conditions, we are also trying out different models because there is no single model which can be replicated in other institutions.
Since our operations commenced in 1998, we promoted about 44 companies, out of which 4 companies have standing of global standards.
Well, I had MIT Innovation Incubator based out of the private university, MIT, which is one of the biggest private universities in India. We incubated around 60 startups in the last 2 years, and it's an equity-based incubator, and our focus area is information communication technology, and we look forward for most of the product companies and which are fundable companies.
We represent Amrita, but we are working closely with Mr. Sujit Banerjee, Mr. Mittal, and all of the TBI managers here to really connect everyone. So why are we here today, or what is this partnership? And what we are showing here today is that what we really need is a knowledge transfer from, we feel, the Silicon Valley tie to India. There are many things that we all talk about, but there are intangible things. You know, people, when they talk about entrepreneurship, they talk about fire in the belly. They talk about instinct. They talk about things that cannot or often are not part of the curriculum. And those things, as spoken earlier, come by instinct, by knowing what to do at the right time. So we feel that kind of knowledge can only be transferred by people closely interacting, and that will lead us to greater heights.
To build a startup, build a scalable enterprise is very, very hard. It is not only hard based on the skills and talent required of the entrepreneurs, just hard to do. Why is it so hard to do? I mean, you start out, like, odds are against you. The establishment is fundamentally against you. As a young startup company, your goal is to find your place amongst the giants. And the giants don't like you. You're like an orphan, okay? I mean, all the establishment doesn't want you. Your family is typically disowned you. I mean, everybody's telling you you're insane, and you still want to do it. So you're like an orphan, and you have no credibility. Nobody wants to buy from you, you have no money, everybody thinks you're going to not survive. So you start with that kind of a handicap, and that is a challenge of a startup.
What's the role of incubator? Are we being misled once again? So some deep thought has to be happened. So let me offer a four-pronged solution, possibly, to why you should not be, it's not a hopeless situation. I believe that the incubator is the wrong word. You gotta come up with a better word. But what you're offering, and I'm very encouraged to talk to many of you, what you're doing, and it's really heartwarming, I mean, many of you I talk to. What you're doing is you're providing this ecosystem when the right people are attracted and guided.
When an entrepreneur is looking for a mentor, you know, they're looking for knowledge and experience that they can relate to within their startup. Second, they're looking from the mentor to get connections, because the mentor themselves may not have answers to everything.
That's, first of all, I never invest in a company. I never invest in an idea or a market. Yeah, they change all the time. Yeah, so I always invest in a person. Yeah, the person has to convince me that it's entrepreneurial. And there are several traits that I look for. And first of all is the trait about being able to withstand the risk environment, taking the risk, and without losing his mind. But also, calculating the risk.
My idea is you have to expose your entrepreneurs to as many successful people as possible. TiE has great speaker program. I mean, video is the second best thing to live, but I would say live is better. And then the idea is make them dream big. India is now a big market, similar to China. And even if they get successful, if they are the number one in India, they are already a world-class startup. If I conclude is, you know, a little bit of ignorance, dreaming big, passion, and then, just kind of thinking to build global companies and exposing your entrepreneurs to as many successful people as possible would be great. Thank you. Thank you.